We've also been hearing from the former FBI Director James Comey, who was, of course, fired by President Trump early on into his administration. He has responded to President Trump's tweet this morning where he made a false statement about the FBI and the Russia probe. Comey writes in that tweet, "This is from the president of our country lying about the lawful execution of a search warrant issued by a federal judge. Shame on Republicans who don't speak up at this moment for the FBI, for the rule of law, and for the truth." Lynn, among Capitol Hill Republicans, there has been a remarkable amount of silence over all these recent developments in the Russia probe. Do you think that that's going to change anytime soon?
I don't think so, because they want to try and there's enough tumult without them. The senators want to especially want to try and move on and not have this further distraction when there's enough out there that they think their voices may not add much to anything. There's also a wait and see situation for when the House Democratic investigations, which are poised to start as soon as the new House is sworn in on January 3rd. But this is a noticeable silence on the part of Republicans of all the turmoil of this week. There are multiple stories, chaos in the administration, the sentencings, the Zinke resignation, new chief of staff, the silence from Republicans on a variety of chaotic events, you know, from dealing with the fabrications right. that Comey wrote about to the list I just recited. It is more than just silence. It's almost, where is the responsibility to talk about how you're going to govern with the president who is intent on taking the course he's taking, and with these tweets that seem to undermine the very foundation of democracy and show a disrespect, which we all know is there, right. for facts.
Tom, is that just because there's no political upside for these Republicans?
Yeah, I mean, we've seen this over and over and over before. When will Republicans in Congress speak out on any number of issues, whether it's related to the Mueller inquiry, whether it's related to other issues? And you look at what's happened politically with the few Republicans who have kind of put their necks out there, Jeff Flake, Bob Corker. I think a lot of Republicans look at this and say there still is just sort of a huge amount of political risk and very little political upside at this point in kind of being the one to stand up and say someone needs to address what's going on here.
And it's really almost the same ones that are willing to speak
right.
out to you
right.
talk to, Susan Collins. So the cast is very small of the Republicans who do say something.
And Susan Collins, you know, from Maine, where
yes.
the base isn't necessarily, where the Republicans there aren't necessarily reflective of the bigger base, and then the other Republicans who are willing to speak up are ones who might not be around much longer. One of the major revelations in the past week was Michael Cohen saying that he lied to Congress about the Trump Tower project, that the president had been updated about the Moscow Trump Tower project far beyond January 2016, when the first caucuses took place, up until June of 2016, when he was the presumptive Republican nominee. So let's listen to what Rudy Giuliani said about that Trump Tower Moscow project earlier today.
Did Donald Trump know that Michael Cohen was pursuing the Trump Tower in Moscow into the summer of 2016?
According to the answer that he gave, it would have covered all the way up to November of 2016. Said he had conversations with him about it. President didn't hide this. They
well,
know.
Earlier they had said those conversations stopped in January 2016.
Until you actually sit down and answer the questions, and you go back and you look at the papers and you look at the trend, you're not going to know what happened. That's why lawyers, you know, prepare for those answers.
Okay, then let me.
Robert, we've also heard the president himself after this came out saying that he didn't know if he was going to become president, so why should he drop his business dealings? What's the legal significance of what Giuliani said right there?
Well, to go back to your prior point, I fundamentally disagree with former Director Comey. I'm a proud Republican. I believe in law and the FBI and truth. But I also know that there was a lot of politics being played early on in this investigation, including regarding the Steele dossier and the failure to disclose the fact that the Hillary Clinton campaign was behind financing it, and also the failure
right.
Before a FISA court to make sure that that was
right.
known and apparent. And then what I subsequently found out this week is that with regard to Michael Flynn, FBI Director Comey, snuck two agents into the White House, unbeknownst to the White House Chief of Staff and the White House counsel's office in order to presumably get him to make false statements about things that they already knew the answers to because they had the transcript of the Kislyak conversation.
Right.
So it strikes me in the first instance, you know, how is whatever Flynn said material to any investigation, since it seems that their apparent purpose was to obtain his statements and then be able to use those against him, as they did to go to Sally Yates, then the acting attorney general, in order to try to have him removed from his position as national security advisor. In other words, right. The intelligence community, what the president has characterized as the deep state, was out to get this guy. Now, you know, I don't know.
Well, but the Mueller team has also said that, you know, someone who ran an intelligence agency and someone who had been in the military for that long should have known better. And it's clear that he should have known
that
lying to federal agents was illegal.
There's no legal requirement for the FBI to have advised him that lying under oath or lying before a federal agent is in fact a crime.
Right.
So no one's trying to excuse the statements.
Right.
But you do have to wonder what was going on. And you know, what the president's point was, which Director Comey completely misses, is that the origins of this investigation are suspect. And that leads people question whether or not politics are being played with a criminal investigation. And as I have said many, many times on many occasions, you know, prosecution should not be politics. By other means.
Robert, can I get your legal reaction to
sure.
what Giuliani said there, and how does that change anything in terms of the president's liability?
Well, I have always wondered, given the fact that I think it was a surprise even to President Trump that he won the election, that making a claim with regard to Russia collusion in the summer of an election year when it wasn't even clear that he would win the presidency always seemed, in my judgment, to be a stretch. He didn't. The Trump campaign had nothing to trade with Russians because it presupposes that you, with the benefit of 2020 hindsight, that they were in a position to be making promises as to what would happen once the Trump administration
right.
took office. That presupposes that he was going to be elected, something that even they didn't believe. And then I look at your caption here about, you know, six different areas where the Trump administration is under investigation. I have to laugh because during the Clinton administration, there were seven independent counsels in place, including my own with regard to Whitewater,
right.
which was just one of seven. So, you know, I get the politics of this.
But that doesn't negate the fact that those are still, those investigations
right.
are very much underway.
If I can make a quick closing point, I know time is short. I think the point here is not a comparison between
right.
administration to administration,
right.
but just, I covered the Clinton White House, and you just cover these investigations as they come. I think that's the point for
right.
our listeners to absorb. It's not a comparison here. It is what's going on right now, and it's where the river flows to.
Thank you. That's an excellent point to end on. Lynn Sweet, Tom Kaplan, and Robert Ray, thank you very much for joining us.